I'll fight the corruption and big spending politicians.
Ask just about any candidate for office why they run.
Because a good education means everything.
And they'll tell you it's to serve their district, their state, or their country. But once they get to Washington, author Peter Schweitzer says money sometimes gets in the way.
Money in politics is not just so much about winning and losing elections anymore. It's more and more about a lifestyle subsidy and extracting as much as you can because you can direct that into your own pocket or your family's pocket.
The ability to do that now made far easier with leadership PACs, non-connected political action committees in which money can be spent independently. Once only held by committee chairmen, today just about every member of Congress has one, and the dollars flowing in have skyrocketed.
The rules on the expenditures and the fundraising for these leadership PACs are a bit more fuzzy than they are in other areas of campaign finance law.
Congressman Andy Harris is now trying to change that.
When someone contributes to any political organization, I think that's what they expect their contribution to do, is to advance their beliefs, to help elect people who are consistent with their beliefs.
Instead, the Government Accountability Institute shows that money is often used by lawmakers for travel, lodging at luxury resorts, and to buy expensive meals, since that's not against the rules.
We should just end any question about it, close the loophole once and for all, remove any question of impropriety.
But Congressman Harris's bill, the Clean Campaign Contributions Act of 2013, hasn't moved very far in Congress. Unlike other pieces of legislation that get dozens or even more than 100 co-sponsors, this one so far only has two. Changing the rules may prove difficult, but Schweitzer says continuing on the current path could be detrimental to a Congress already in a negative light with voters.
We have elected officials from both parties in Washington whose lives and experiences are totally divorced from what the rest of the country is facing.
An uphill battle to change that now being fought in Washington. I'm Christine Frizzell reporting.